I think what makes this process different than any of the previous attempts is we really are focused on separating the streams up front, right? So we have different modules for processing urine than we have for processing feces than we have for processing flush water, right? So we look at processing those in different ways. They have different energy demands on them. And by processing three separate streams, we think we can get to a lower cost, lower energy system.
So you immediately have to separate the three.
Luckily, your body naturally separates. There are different trajectories that happen. And when it comes down to urine and flush water, there are different flow rates. So we actually are very lucky. The wisdom of putting everything into a bowl, mixing it all together, this is where thermodynamics comes in, because when you mix it all together, it's really difficult then to separate, and you have to put a lot more energy in to then separate.
Well, that's how, and even kind of how I ask that question, because I think that's what we experience is immediate mixing. I mean, that's what,
that's right.
As far as I can tell, all toilets in the U.S. are oriented towards.
Exactly. Yeah. So for this problem, right, if we want to achieve low cost, we really have to achieve a highly energy efficient system, right? So focusing on heat transfer and thermodynamics really allows us to be on a trajectory to achieve a low cost system.